गुड मॉर्निंग मैम। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
हाय गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू ऑल डूइंग?
मैम जस्ट डूइंग एवर
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन।
आई एम ओके। सो आई फर्स्ट हैव टू अपोलोजाइज। आई नो यू ऑल वांटेड मी टू बी देयर ऑन द सरस्वती पूजा, राइट? But it was I just felt sick and I could not come. And I haven't looked at the program yet, but I will. How was the program?
Ma'am, I haven't watched it completely, but it felt good. Like I went to another ceremony.
Oh, okay. So all the Valentine's Day, Saraswati Puja, a lot of festivals, and it's all over, right? Time to be back for trainings.
Yes, ma'am. Although Valentine's Day doesn't matter for me, I am happily single. So Saraswati Puja, yeah, it does matter. So I went to one of my religious places. Like from the childhood only I am going over there, so I felt good over there, so that was good. The day was quite good.
Okay, that's nice. But I am, you know what the exciting part was? I met some of you, right, on that day.
Okay. I did not go to the college.
No, I went on Saturday and I met Tripti, I met Shomadeep, I think. No, Shomadeep Huta.
That's Shomadeep Huta, I think so.
Yeah, so I met. So are they aren't there today? Where are the rest of them?
They were there, I don't know, let me see just a sec. Yeah, they are there, okay. They're there.
Okay, I'm not going to start the class unless you all start talking. Tell me like a quick recap of what we did in the last class.
I mean, the last class you have given a task to me, Nilanjan and Tripti about that cultural group formation and all. So we did that accordingly and we have collected the names too.
Okay, so that is done, right? So we were supposed to start with interpersonal skills today, right?
Yes, ma'am, exactly.
Okay, so let's start with that. Everybody ready with that? So once when we start with interpersonal skills, it's very important that we are in a discussion as well. Are you all ready with that?
Yes, ma'am.
Raja ne Tenali ko
yes, ma'am.
Okay. So according to you, what do you all understand by interpersonal skills? What do you all think? What is interpersonal skills?
Interpersonal skills.
You can speak in any language. Yeah, Niranjan.
Yes, ma'am. Interpersonal skills are those skills that we use every day when we communicate or interact with other peoples, and that may be in individual or maybe in group. And actually, this includes various type of skills, particularly communication skills, that is you can say listening and effective speaking, public speaking, that also includes the ability to control and manage our emotions.
Okay, so name some of your some interpersonal skills. So communication skill, listening skill, I know. What else?
Speaking skills are there, then how can you speak properly with others, how can you interact with others,
problem solving skills, decision making skills, leadership quality.
Okay, what about others? Kothay acche shobai?
Interpersonal skills are, hello ma'am, excuse me.
Yes, Nizamuddin.
Interpersonal skills are those we use every day to communicate and interact with others, including listening, speaking and questioning skills. They are there.
Okay, so
ma'am, I think interpersonal, that skill represent us.
Exactly. That is the first thing. Interpersonal, very good. You know, full on for this. So, interpersonal skill is the one that talks about what you are. So now, for example, okay, we want to make, say, Nilanjan wants to make chicken and Shomadeep wants to make chicken. So what do you need for making chicken? You need the raw chicken, you need ginger, garlic, spice, right? Maybe some yogurt or whatever. Yes. So, right? So these are your ingredients. So these are basically the raw skills in you. So, you know, when, say, suppose Nilanjan makes his recipe, mixes, puts a little more garlic and a little less of ginger and a little more of yogurt, whereas say Shomadeep makes a little less of ginger but a lot of spices. So, you know, ultimately the chicken item that comes to you is going to taste different.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So overall, that item that is given to you, that is what we call as interpersonal skill. Means every person has everything in them. You know, you all have communication skills, listening skills, decision making skills, talking to other person, your behavior, your gestures, your facial expressions. But ultimately, when you mix all of this together and bring forward that person, that is what we call as interpersonal skill. And everyone will have their own proportion of these skills, right? And that is why it is called interpersonal skills, because it's a mixture of all these skills in one, and that represents you, what you are as a person. Okay, now
yes,
this is interpersonal skill, which means that somebody can see you. Jeta dekha jaye, right? When you're showing yourself, so you're carrying yourself in a way to in front of the people, you know, talking in a way. That is inter, like something that you can see. What is intrapersonal skills? So intrapersonal skill is a little different from interpersonal skills. Intra is something that happens inside.
Like it can be some internal class that we are having with myself only, like,
yes, so that, yes. Exactly. That's a more of psychological part. We'll study them a little later, right? So there we talk a lot about your emotional intelligence. You're talking about how you're handling your emotions, how you're dealing with your shortcomings, how, you know, all of these things. That is intra, something that people cannot see. But interpersonal skill is something that people can see, can look at you. Now, why I told you all to write the name was because I wanted you all to understand that each one of you have a lot of skills amongst, you know, yourself. You all have a lot of skills, but most of the times you yourself don't realize that you have that skill.
Yes.
So that is like, you know, for example, I'll say there are dancers here, there are singers here. So, you know, it's said that the dancers, they can express well. You know, they will have a good way of expressions. So that is one of your interpersonal skill. A singer who would know how to connect with his audience, to, you know, sing a song that appeals to the audience, right? So certain interpersonal skills are needed. An artist will have a creative outlook. So many such things. So, that is why I always say that creativity is an equal part of, you know, a personality building. It is an equal part of making yourself what you are. And it's just not related to, you know, music, dance, art, or anything like that, but it's also related to the kind of trainings that you're doing, the kind of workshops that you're doing, the subjects that you're studying. Even on that, how you express yourself, how you talk about it. See, I mean, I understand there are so many of you out there. Some of you might not be able to talk very, they are very must be very good with your with your subject knowledge, okay, but you know the subject very well, but you're not able to make the other person understand the concept, then there's no use, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So that is what I exactly meant by interpersonal skill, is that to believe that, first of all, that you all have, you know, everyone is born with more than one, two, you know, skills. It's just that, and you develop some skills in your lifetime. So slowly and gradually, this all refines you and makes you the person that you are. That day when I went in the college, I looked at a lot of students and I felt like, you know, you need to know how to walk, you need to know how to wear your clothes, you need to know how to have the right gesture to talk. So there were a lot of things that I noticed, because probably I have an eye for that. But I want you all, since you're in your first year now, to get started. I still see there are a lot of people who are not talking still. Now tell me something, whatever I told you now, did you all understand? Did you all understand?
Yes, understand.
Anybody who wants me to say in Bengali, make you repeat the whole thing in Bengali?
Can I ask you something out of this topic?
Yeah, sure.
Ma'am, are you feeling down or feeling low today? Like, is there something that is going on in you?
Yeah, I'm not well, actually. I was supposed to be hospitalized today, but I did not go. So I thought maybe I should do the class with you all.
What happened, ma'am? What happened to you, ma'am? Like, is it serious?
It's a long story. So I came back home that day, and Sunday, Monday. So from Tuesday, I started feeling not well. So I was not feeling well. I thought, I don't know what is going on. Then I got fever. I started getting fever. So the fever was quite high. And then I started with that all sort of corona symptoms, you know, like losing the taste and shortness of breath and all of that. And I thought, you know, I'm all hit by corona. So I did all my tests, everything. But fortunately, unfortunately, I was not tested negative. I was tested negative. So now I did all rest of the tests. You know, in India, Kolkata, all the doctors would make you do so many tests. And I've been given so many medicines that for last, 5 days, I was not able to get up from my bed. So then yesterday also, I was not feeling well. So I finally went to the hospital and they could not diagnose what is going on. But something is going wrong. So I'm still facing the shortness of breath, and I'm not feeling okay. Don't worry, I'm okay.
Ma'am, you should go to the hospital instead of taking class.
Ma'am, have you measured your SpO2 level?
Yeah, like, but there is some kind of infection. But I had a severe diarrhea infection just not even 3 weeks back. So I think there's something going on in my stomach. Either it's there is an inflammation or there is something with the liver, or I don't know what. I mean, I have to do an USG, and actually they wanted me to get admitted and, you know, be there. They wanted to keep me in observation, and but I didn't want to do that. I am very scared of hospitals, and for some reason I have a block. I've seen like whoever goes to hospital never comes back, so I didn't want to go there. So that's why I thought I'll just you know, I have my medicine. I have an appointment probably tomorrow, so I'll say don't worry, I'll be fine in some time. It's just that I'm like a little getting short of breath, right? So you got it.
Okay, ma'am. So right? Just seek for an attention as soon as possible, like from doctor's attention.
Yeah, I know. That is there.
If there's an inflammation, the antibiotics and all the doctor that will give you, like, it won't be able to stop that inflammation, because inflammation is something that has already been caused. Like antibiotic stops the bacteria, but it cannot stop the inflammation. So you need to take steroids type things to stop the.
I don't know exactly.
Yeah.
I never felt sick ever before like that. So I'm a little skeptical about what is going on.
And you could have visited today only, because a single day delay like means a lot in medical field. You could have visited today only.
It's not that they wanted me to be there admitted for 1 or 2 days.
Then most probably, if you have a insurance, like you can go cashless, you can go to a hospital and just give the insurance.
That is not a problem. That is not the problem. It's just that I didn't want to. I'm very scared of all these medicines and everything. So okay. I did not get an appointment today for the USG. So maybe I'll do it tomorrow. So that's
fine. Okay, mom, all right. Don't worry, ma'am. We'll be good. We'll be good in the next week only. You'll get back your full energy, ma'am.
Yeah. Hopefully, I will. Yeah. Okay. So I'm gonna share the screen. Okay. You know how my screen sharing skills are. Okay, you can see this, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, see, interpersonal skills are the life skills. Yes, they are also called life skills because it gives you the, you know, the way to live life, right? So that is why they are called life skills. You know, there are few more skills which are called life skills. Life skills are those skills which you cannot forget in life. Once you know, adapt to that skill, once you know that skill, you will you won't forget that skill. That is why they are called life skills, something that you get it inside you. So you tell me now, tell me two more skills. Those are life skills that you generally learn it. No, just two. There are many, but.
Ma'am, cycling, swimming.
Good, good, very good. Yes, walking. Absolutely. Driving, correct. Skating, you know, all these things. They are like there. That's why they are called life skills. So once you all, you know, learn that, the basic skills that we are talking about, the interpersonal skills, you will never forget it in your life. So we use every day to communicate and interact with other people, both individually and in groups. People who have worked on developing strong interpersonal skills are usually more successful in both their professional and personal life. So it's very obvious, right? I mean, if you have a good interpersonal skill, definitely people are you know, going to appreciate you, like you. So wherever you're desirable, you become successful. So why do we need interpersonal skills? Now here, you tell me, according to you, what do you all think, that why do we need interpersonal skills?
And first of all, to represent ourselves and then to mingle with the society.
What else?
Ma'am, it's maybe make happier.
It makes, okay, quite close. So hum kotha theke porashona kore
relax.
So hum kotha theke porashona kore esche interpersonal.
No ma'am, no ma'am.
Okay. It is for definitely for the in, see what happens is, like, when you all start working in organizations, hardcore corporate life, there are a lot of people who has you know, depicted behavior, like you're expected to be in that kind of behavior. So what happens if you do not carry the right interpersonal skill? So you will be left behind, because your visibility goes down, which means your, so what happens there, ekta hoy na je tumi pichone theke jaccho, you're not able to cope up. You're coping up with the work, but you're not able to cope up with the culture. You're not able to cope up with the emotional intelligence. You're not able to cope up with the discrepancies. So ultimately what happens is you get disheartened. And therefore it affects your efficiency, which means your efficiency is affected, means your money is affected. So interpersonal skill is basically how to handle your personality in particular, you know, places, like in an organization, in an institution, in a marriage ceremony, in a family occasion. You know, suppose there is a family occasion, kothao tomar barite, say younger sister is getting married or elder sister is getting married, so you go ahead and do a lot of work, smile, and you know, express your expressions by talking, welcoming. That is the kind of behavior, expected behavior in that ceremony, in that situation. But had it been there is a party organized in your company, in the organization, you will not have the similar kind of excitement and enthusiasm. You will show it, but in a different manner. Are you getting,
yes,
what I'm saying? So that,
yes,
is what we need. And why we need that? Because you have to maintain certain gestures. You need to maintain a little kind of certain kind of behavior that can, you know, bring you or put you in the right place, right? At a khaper madhe you have to fit in, right? If you do not fit in, you'll see there are loops. মানে একটু ফাঁক রয়ে যাচ্ছে সব জায়গায়, সো ওই ফাঁক থেকে ইউ আ লট অফ নেগেটিভিটি গেটিং ইন অর থিংস গেটিং ইন, উইচ ইজ হোয়াট মেকিং ইয়োর ইউ নো অ্যাডাপটিভ ফিটিং ইন লুজার, মানে ওটা ফিট ইন করতে পারছে না, ওই লুপহোলস গুলো যখন থেকে যাচ্ছে তখন ওইটা দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি টেকিং ইউ আউট অফ দ্য প্লেস. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
তাই জন্য ইউ হ্যাভ টু ফিট ইন টু এভরি কাইন্ড অফ কালচার অ্যান্ড সিচুয়েশনস সো দ্যাট ইজ ওয়াই উই নিড ইন্টারপার্সোনাল স্কিলস ওকে নাও what happens why interpersonal skills are needed because improve for improving your power of expression now how many of you understand by power of expression kate bole
ma'am the way that we like actually the power of expression is the way how we express ourselves in different kind of situation
yes
and so, very well
power of expression ta onekta emotional and experience er shonge related thake ami korabo tomaderke which is called ethos and pathos of a speech which we'll do in details so that is called which means like tumi dekhbe onek speakers ra onekei they talk about their personal experiences right and then they talk about the cause right
yes ma'am
yes
abar just give me a second okay oh wait abar there are speakers who you will see that they sometimes have tears in their eyes when they are talking and you know they so what they are trying to do is they are trying to connect with their audience which makes your speech powerful okay are you understanding a little bit of it
yes ma'am and that's how in a movie the actors
yes,
make more like cheerful and more connectable
yes so that is what we call as you know power of expression how powerful you are in your expressions basically in your speech in your conversation so whenever like when you connect with someone how do you think a person would remember you it is just not the bad even you see a lot of you know the stand up comedians they generally mock about themselves but actually they are generalizing it right
yes
you know you've seen right all these stand up comedians ora nijederke niye hashe mane nijer kotha bole hashe kintu actually nijeke bolche na right
yes
yes ma'am
that is called that is a kind of this is a kind of speech it is a kind of you know connecting with people so that is called power of expression okay then comes being accountable anybody who can tell me what is the meaning of being accountable
ma'am it's মানে অনন্য হয়ে ওঠা মানে অনেকের মধ্যে একজন যেটা গোনার মধ্যে পড়া আর কি
No,
it's like taking the responsibility for what we have done like it's like okay we have done this like it's being responsible actually kind of
being taking the responsibility of your own action or you know your work suppose somebody told you your boss told you you know you need to finish this testing by next week and you come and say okay this sir I tried a lot I could not connect him he was in US time zone whenever I called him he was sleeping and you cannot have these kind of you know complaints when you go to workplaces so you have to be accountable of the work that you do so if you don't want to do something or you are doubtful about the fact that you will be able to do it or not then that you need to say and express it right away so I will do some sort of you know questions that I'll bring in front of you and I will want to see how you answer them okay so in our maybe next class or next to next class we'll do that eglo bhalo kore shune rakho if you want note it down write it down because you know your answers will be based on this kind of a mindset so being accountable Okay. Now, improving self-management skills. This is, I think, this should be the first point, because a lot of us do not know what self-management is.
I know a little bit of self-management skills.
Well, say that.
Like, ma'am, the ability of stress management and time management, you can say, and our set goal set goal setting and our decision making skills, our confidence and time management I think I have said that.
Time management is the first thing that comes in self-management skills. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And as self-management first includes self-discipline. A person cannot manage himself or herself unless that person is disciplined in the fact that I listen to myself. And, you know, no matter what, if I decide that I have, suppose, how many of you follow a routine in your class?
Because of this heavy, our tight schedule, I can't follow the nowadays properly my schedule.
So, you know, the fact that, you know, in the morning I'll wake up at this time, I'm going to have my, you know, lemon juice, I'm going to go for a walk, or I'm going to exercise and then have my breakfast, and then I'm going to work from this hour to this hour. Work is something, it's going to be for forever. It's never ending thing. But then in between, you know, I'll do some course and all of this. And what I'm saying is, like, making yourself work in a way that you know how to manage your things, because believe me, this is the best time in your life. After this, you'll never get time. After your college life, yes. After you start working, you'll never get time. So you need to know how you're distributing yourself, where you're putting yourself, in a way that, you know, you can have, and you should also have your own time, you know, in whatever you want to do, watching a movie or music or anything, you know, going out, having a cup of coffee, relaxing with a friend of yours. So all those things also needs, you know, so that part of you, you need to schedule and you need to follow and see how many days you can do that. If you think you're doing it for years, so that means you already have it. If you started a few days back, you stopped, then you know that where you need to work. So what I'm saying is, self-management skills improve fully, interpersonal skills on it to improve fully. And okay, improved emotional quotient, you know. Using stress to win is something which I don't believe, so I'm not going to tell you about that. Usually a lot of people believe that when you are in pressure, you perform. Yes? HRA, bola hai, je, jokhan pressure dao, release date is there, okay? So they start pressurizing you. But if you, just a second, to wash up, question. But if you, so I was saying, I missed what I was saying. So they believe that, you know, to pressure thou, to performance, you know, you'll perform. So what I'm saying is, yes, if you pressurize, there is a performance, but too much of stress or pressure might not be an effective performance at times.
Yes, ma'am. I also believe that.
So that way I'm saying, okay, just a moment. How do I stop the screen share? Every day I face this problem.
Ma'am, please go to that meeting that in your taskbar, that go to meeting app, please go through that.
Yeah,
there will you will find that screen presenting off that button you will find. Go to the down below of your taskbar. Go to your taskbar.
This one?
No, ma'am, are you seeing the Windows logo down? Like Windows logo, type here to search. Or are you just in a windowed screen in GoToMeeting app only? Like, are you inside the GoToMeeting app?
Yes, I am.
Ma'am is inside the GoToMeeting app, and from there the screen is being shared. Like, we are not seeing the GoToMeeting app, but ma'am is inside it. Like, it's a laptop interface. Okay, like, it's confusing, I know, like, but it's still the laptop interface. Last time also ma'am faced this.
It shows leave me.
And if you face this type of problem, please leave and rejoin. that can be easy.
Okay. No, you don't need to rejoin. Just a second. Give me a second. I don't know, can't even see the camera.
Hello, ma'am.
I think ma'am has muted herself. I don't know.
Ma'am has left, I think.
Yeah, maybe. Ma'am is there as a presenter. See, like, you can
just check. Is admin, okay. Oh,
the admin is ma'am only. Like, ma'am hasn't changed her name.
Ma'am is there. Ma'am is moving her cursor.
Yeah, that's admin moving
her the mouse presenter. Cursor. I'm telling her cursor. By mistake, I think ma'am has muted and ma'am is now unable to unmute.
I think ma'am was like presenting from two sides, like one as a presenter and like one as a like from the camera also. She was presenting from that. So ma'am has left there.
Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
You are audible, ma'am. But we are.
You can't see me, right?
No, ma'am. See you.
Okay, listen.
Now we can
see. I still could not do this. So I have a small appointment with the doctor. I think, and we are also done with the class, right? Almost. Oh no, we're not. Okay.
Ma'am, it's okay. You can like
go and visit. It's not necessary that you will end our class. You can go, ma'am.
Yeah, and that's fine.
That is important for you.
Okay, so I'm going to tomorrow we're going to start with. So just before ending, so like interpersonal skills. Now imagine we're going to do three buckets. Okay, the first bucket is communication skill. So now here, when we do communication skills, I'm going to tell you about different types of speeches. I'm going to tell you that how every speech should be spoken about, all of that. Okay.
Okay.
So from next day, we're going to talk about that.
Are you going to take the classes tomorrow? Take our class, because tomorrow is, I don't think that is your class.
I think sir said I'm going to have a class, but I don't know. So if I have an appointment in the morning, like how I said about it, then probably I will not. And if I manage to come back, and then I will start. Maybe if I start 10 minutes later also, that's fine, right?
Mm-hmm. That will be good, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Take care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Take care, ma'am.
Yeah, I will. Thank you.
I wish you a speedy recovery, ma'am. Thank you.